You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
John McAfee is going to be joining us, of course, of McAfee antivirus software to break down exactly what's happening with the so-called security of the cloud and to detail exactly why the police and FBI lie about the mystery cell towers around the country that really aren't mysteries at all. That's in the third hour. For the first 2 hours, we're going to open the phones up and cover the waterfront on this live Wednesday, the 17th of September, 2014, worldwide broadcast. I am your host, Alex Jones. Obviously, the Ebola situation, in Obama's words, is spiraling out of control and is a serious threat. And they've committed 3,000 troops as of yesterday to go into these five African, now six African nations, but they're going to be in five countries, two particularly that are ravaged and where the governments are close to collapsing and society is close to spiraling into anarchy. And a total of 6,000 other UN troops are going to be sent who are not trained and properly equipped to be around Ebola in a hot zone. And you can argue, do they go in and, quote, contain it? That means shooting people that try to exit areas or cross borders and putting them into giant ghettos to basically die. That's on record what they're doing. Or is it really just going to be putting troops into a hot zone where they can gestate this for 22 days and bring it back into the United States? And undoubtedly there's some Typhoid Marys in there who have got Ebola or will get Ebola, who are master carriers, who carry it a lot longer than 22 days. So we're going to be breaking it all down here today. I want to just say the crew and Rob Dew and everybody did a fabulous job yesterday. I had a stomachache in the morning, and in the old days I would just come in if I had a stomachache or something, but I just decided to take off and get some rest. So I did do that, but ended up working in the afternoon. But it's just wonderful to be able to have an arsenal of great minds here to help fill in when I can't do the broadcast, like Paul Watson, Rob Dew, and the rest of the reporters. Just amazing that we have such an informed team, like our news director on the TV side, Rob Dew, who can just step in here, never doing a radio show in his life other than filling in some here as a guest and host a radio show that's in the top 10 talk shows, political talk shows in the country. And in the top five political websites now, and you can look that up for yourself. So pretty powerful arsenal of researchers and political minds that we now have here. We're finally getting a little bit of depth in our operation, something that we desperately need so we can expand with our reporters and our research and our analysis and cover more in depth of what's happening here on our planet. So great job to the crew. Dozens of children feared dead after being injected with tainted measles vaccine in Syria by the UN. And who carried it out? The loving rebels. When they're not nerve-gassing children or chopping their heads off, they're vaccinating them. It doesn't matter that it's on record that the rebels are the ones doing it. They're trying to blame Assad, who I'm not saying is a cupcake of goodness, but quite frankly, I can't find a lot he's done to say that's bad other than being a dictator. Kind of a semi-benevolent, not malevolent, compared to Al-Qaeda, that is. Certainly, he was trying to democratize, and they used that as a way to get in there and overthrow much of the nation. But Kurt Nemo wrote a detailed article about it, showing how it's a lot more than 36 children and it's excruciating how they died. We're going to get into the latest on just a host of issues straight ahead. Stay with us. The entire InfoWars crew and family, thank you again so much for joining us on this Wednesday, the 17th day of September 2014. We're going to be live, as I said, here for the next 3 hours. There's a new poll out. We'll be getting into some out of Gallup. Trust in mass media at all-time low. 1 billion websites and counting. Yahoo News is now reporting. Police are now using drones to photograph car wrecks. That's just some of the type of news that's up on drudgereport.com. Up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, dozens of children dead after UN gives tainted vaccine in rebel-held Syria. U.S. and Saudi-backed mercenaries blame Assad fantastically. Kurt Nemo wrote that story, and the story links to the London Telegraph and to the World Health Organization. Dozens of children feared dead after being injected with tainted measles vaccine in Syria. We're going to go over the horrible deaths, writhing in pain right after getting the vaccines that resembled what cyanide does. And what's amazing is it's admitted to be a UN program. It's admitted to be in rebel-held areas, but then the rebels blame Assad. Kind of like there's video of them going, holla, 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 last year, 15 months ago, and launching chemical attacks on multiple sites inside Syria, waving al-Qaeda flags. And then our news media would say, oh, Assad did it. And then even the UN tested the chemicals and said, no, it's Saudi Arabian. I mean, it's pretty obvious when Obama goes 2 years ago, if we see anyone launch chemical weapons, rebels or Assad, we're going to bomb Assad and blame him. That's our red line. In fact, it was on the anniversary, so it was 2.5 years ago, the anniversary of Obama's red line statement and speech that the rebels launched the chemical attack. The first one of three. Remember all this? Early part of 2013? And then Obama came out in March, a year later, and said the red line has been crossed. The globalists are such gangsters, it's so obvious. If any chemical weapons get used, we're going to blame Assad. A year later, al-Qaeda launches the attack against Assad and against the army, and then blames them. And then now, in the London Telegraph, in Der Spiegel, in the World Health Organization's own statement, it's a UN program in the north in an area seized by the, quote, good rebels. I am not a bad witch. I am a Glinda, the good witch, to quote the Lollipop Guild speech in Wizard of Oz. It's like we're going to arm the rebels to fight the rebels. It's all oxymorons. It's all up is down, down is up, black is white, 2 + 2 equals whatever they say. It is just so crazy. But then there's the whole discussion of why in Pakistan, why in Libya, why all over Africa? Do the 50 years ago, the natives would beg for the white medicine man's medicine. Now they run because they give them shots and the whole village gets HIV, or they give them shots and the whole village is sterilized, or they give them the polio vaccine and half the kids in the town become paralyzed and a bunch of them die. I mean, I see this in the press all the time, and it's almost like it's a conditioning or a psychological inoculation, titrating the poison of tyranny, where now I see articles about them vaccinating people and, them dying, and it's not even a news issue anymore. I am being conditioned to accept it. Oh, I saw on a local newscast an 11-year-old girl, a cheerleader, it's always a cheerleader for some reason, took the shot. So, mommy didn't want her to ever get cancer again, even though it doesn't protect you from cancer, even the papillomavirus. It says on the insert, oh, there's thousands of strains. This only covers 4 to 8 or whatever it says. There's different variants of it. And it doesn't protect you and might give you Guillain-Barré or irritable bowel syndrome or autoimmune or might kill you. And now I see those articles every few days where somebody new dies from it. India, Japan banned it years ago. It was introduced there 8 years ago, like here. But not in America. All over the world, GMOs are being pulled off the shelves. All over the world, glyphosate is being banned or restricted. Look at this article. Nestle removes GMO ingredients from baby foods in South Africa, but not in the USA. Company actively ignores request of U.S. consumers. Another great article by Christina Sarich for Infowars.com from Natural Society. You see, we are the dumping ground for everything. Here's the Globe and Mail. U.S. lawmakers want to curb antibiotic use on farms.